staff is recommending that the council consider the recommendation from the street naming committee to name the new street Roy Diaz Street in honor of the lone local survivor of Company C 194 Tank Battalion who served in the Pacific World War II. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to answer.
Okay. Any questions from council? Okay. Any public comment? All right. Back to council for comments.
Motion to approve.
Second.
Okay. Before we, well, I'll tell you what, we're going to go ahead and call for the question, and then I hope we will have the honor of hearing from you. Are you up to that? Then you, as we call for the question, democracy in action, which you you serve so, the cause you serve so well, why don't you head your way to the, can he make it to the podium, or do you want to, James, you want to bring a mic over to him, and then we'll, I'll bring the plaque down. So we will call for the question.
Councilmember Barrera?
Aye.
Councilmember Craig?
Aye.
Councilmember Lutz?
Aye.
Councilmember Sanchez?
Yes.
Mayor Donahue?
Yes, absolutely, yes. Let's see, I think we're
I want to thank the city council. It told me the name of the street. I'm looking at that movie and I thought back too much to remember. I should get people all over and travel about like us. Shit, I was in prison camp the first time. Better than that commander one. detail too bad. I don't want to go ahead. Go ahead. Dug the grave. You couldn't dig no further than 2.5 or 3 feet deep. You put to about 20 people in there. One hole, two, the other, pull them down with a shovel. They got three certain ones all through, and the legs stick it up. Arms, oh boy. So, that's mentioned now. We were self-supporting down there. I was in Komodi, they call it Komodi, but they had two potato fields. And they had the rice field and all of that stuff. They didn't put me as a boss in the Komodi field. That was something. The boss, it was time to quit. He took home everything to the house. Big bottle of sake.
Thank you. Do you want to? Why don't we?
Looks good. Thank you.
Okay, a couple things. We have three presentation items, and I know we, and we're going to go ahead and get started. I may go out of order with public comment because I gather there's a group that will include school children, so they have homework to do. So I'm going to be mindful of that. I know where if I were to take a vote on the importance of education, I would be able to run the table on that vote. So, but I don't see everyone. So we're going to go ahead and get started with, I think, a particularly exciting project involving Closter Park. And I'm going to recognize my friend, Councilmember Barrera, who I know he's very excited about this project. So, Tony? Yes.
Well, I want to thank you. I'm very humbled this evening by a great group of people that have made a commitment to improve their community. The Rotary model is service above self. The four-way test, one, is it the truth? Is it fair to all concerned? Will it build goodwill and better friendships? And will it be beneficial to all concerned? I've had a privilege of meeting some new friends in our community, and I'm gonna give the Salinas Rotary president the honor of introducing this team, Mr. Brett Harold. Thank you.
Brett, welcome.
Thank you. I thought I was going to be nervous, but there's enough Rotarians to form a new club in here. So if you're interested in joining us, we'd certainly love to have you. And I see some of my fellow Rotarians up there, so I'll calm down just a little bit. My name is Brett Harrell, and I'm the president of the Rotary Club of Salinas. In an unprecedented collaboration, the five Rotary Clubs in Salinas, Northeast, Steinbeck, Alisal, Corral de Tierra, and Salinas, along with Rotary Clubs in Agra and Madras, India, and Mazatlan and Ensenada, Mexico, and the Rotary Foundation have partnered to take on a major renovation of Closter Park. Why now? Because despite the generosity of these clubs to international projects, collectively, they have sponsored trips to assist people in Argentina, Peru, the Micronesian island of Kosrae, funded scholarships in India, and all sorts of other international projects. We believe that it's important at this time to have a major impact right here in our community. Why this project? We began looking for a local project that would have a significant community impact more than 16 months ago. Thanks to Tony Barrera, we were able to identify that project. Closter Park is located in one of Salinas' most important and most densely populated neighborhoods and is the most utilized park in Salinas. What do we hope to accomplish? To create a safe place for families, to engage the community and create a sense of ownership of the community in the park, to reflect the cultural values of that local community, and to demonstrate the power of Rotary and the community working together hand in hand. Where are we? Last night, we had our second of two community meetings at St. Mary's Church, and it was powerful. We are more and more convinced that this is the right project at the right time. We are also in the middle of fundraising. This is a major project. The budget is in the neighborhood of $350,000. And while we can tell you today, we just received $10,000 from the Sally Church Foundation. We are also in a fundraising mode, and we have a BRIC program and encourage as many of you as possible to participate. In a minute, I'll have John Lewis, who is the project director, give some specifics on timing and the building project. But the last issue, what would we like from the city of Salinas? Your encouragement, your cooperation, and your support in any way you can give it. Thank you. This is John Lewis, our project director.
Thanks, Brett. John, welcome.
Thank you. Well, Mr. Mayor, the council, members of the staff, members of the community, fellow Rotarians, Mom, Dad, it's my distinct honor to give you some details on this wonderful project for the city. La Plaza Rotario para nuestra comunidad, for those of you who speak Spanglish like me, it's for our community, and this project is definitely for our community. Let me give you a little bit of background. Closter Park has been a staple in this community for a long time. And is in the middle of the Alisal district. This is an overlay of the park and our construction plans. I'll be getting into them in more detail throughout the presentation, but just to give you sort of an idea, you've got our kiosco, which is the center of our project, which is here in the center of the park, not getting involved with the Little League fields here. Got a boxing ring that I'm going to tell you about, a tutoring center, and where this project originated with La Placita up in the corner. Should give you an idea for those of you in the audience that don't know exactly where Closter Park is. The Steinbeck Center is this red dot here, and Closter Park is over here, like I said, in East Alisal. It's an overview of the neighborhood surrounding the park. It also happens to be right next to the largest Catholic diocese and the county of Monterey, with 4,000 members of their congregation. Our community outreach committee, headed by Ricky Cabrera and Louis Featheroff, have done a fantastic job of engaging all of these folks that live in these homes that are surrounding the park. They're very enthusiastic about the project. This was something that was promised to them on a small scale back in 2006. And they're anything but emotional that their park is going to be a safe place to congregate and get to know their neighbors. In 2006, the leadership class developed a portion of this project, and they called it La Placita. They did a wonderful job of the design. They engaged the community, and they did a wonderful job of publicity. Their intent was to get more eyes in the park and to beautify a section of the park, in addition to the youth work-study program that I'll be talking to you a little bit about in the tutoring center. But most importantly, while there's some wonderful things going on in this area of the community, we're still battling crime and riffraff. And so by getting more eyes in the park, we do know one thing, that it pushes those banditos and the riffraff out. I was approached by Brett Harrell about 15 months ago and asked if I would be the construction portion of this small project. And I said, sure. It wasn't more than a couple of weeks later that we met with the other four Rotary clubs of Salinas, and it has turned into what you're about to see. So the first idea when the five Rotary clubs of Salinas came together was a kiosco. And if you go to any community within Mexico, or even you see some neighboring communities around us, including Watsonville and Paso Robles, that have really a sense of community within their city, one of the staples or the focal points is a kiosco. Lino Belli from Belli Architectural Group was involved in this project from the very beginning, has done a huge effort and really made this thing a success. But these are some of the kioscos that his team got from Mexico. Pictures from Mexico is the inspiration to the sort of the focal point for our project. These are used typically for quinceañeras, weddings, for bandas, mariachis, anything really to get the community together and get folks interacting with each other. So as you see, we got to work on the taking the La Placita into what was now called La Plaza Rotario. All right, so here's an overlay of the park. On the left, you've got bird's eye photo of the existing. And then this is the plan for the new park on the right. I'm going to break down a few of the components for you. Last night, I gave a presentation to Leadership Salinas Valley Class 30 and encouraged their team to get involved into a project which will be taking care of the fountain here in La Placita. La Placita is this area here that they decided to beautify and get more eyes in the park. That will be a part of our project. In addition to that, there's a gentleman by the name of Dan Lujan who's doing, you know, some phenomenal work out in this area. This gentleman is bringing, you know, 30 to 40 people into his boxing gym. A lot of those used to be the member of, I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with the Bread Box, but it's bringing, you know, arch rival gang members into the same room, engaging in healthy activity and exercise and breaking down walls that have been built for generations. President Brett and I went in there one afternoon to visit with the gentleman, and there was 30 to 40 students in there. No gang colors, no affiliations, but you can tell that they definitely came from some of those neighborhoods. Unfortunately, the walls and the ceiling and the floor were all covered with perspiration because the ventilation in that area is really bad. They're exercising strenuously. So one of the things that we're gonna do in our project is put in new windows, a ventilation system, repaint the interior of the building, and install new flooring. This little building that's connected to it is a tutoring center. We've already gotten five brand new computers, complete computers donated. We're also going to be putting in an encyclopedia, both in English and Spanish, and a dictionary set. We're gonna be involving our Interact students, which is a component of Rotary, to be running that center for us. So the focal point, and what you've heard a lot about, is this kiosco over here. The design sort of replicates this one on this side. And it's in the center of this plaza that folks can come, like, from the church and from areas of the community, walk down these paths and sort of congregate in the plaza. A close-up picture of the plaza. This was actually one of the first designs. You can see here in the corner there's a wheelchair lift that we have to be for American Disabilities Act compliance. That now, as you'll see in a moment, is actually a ramp that goes off to the side here. There's approximately 750 4x8-inch bricks that will be for sale, that are for sale now. There's my pitch. We sold quite a few today at our Rotary club meeting. They're going to be $100, and you can put three lines and 15 characters of your business and memory of, or your own name, and the proceeds of that will go towards the project. Also, some of the other elements of the plaza are some planters and some benches and lighting on the outside. There's a building section of the actual kiosco. Eliminate the stairs. We don't have stairs anymore. We've got a ramp. But essentially what this structure is it's an elevated stage. It's about 4 feet off the ground with poles that are suspending a roof, and the top of the roof is going to be as high as maybe 25 to 30 feet. It's a very beautiful structure. We've put a Belly Architectural Group has put a lot of thought and design into this, that this roof is going to be copper. We're going to have a lot of ornamental iron and that sort of stuff, making it very aesthetically pleasing. Some more renderings of the kiosco. We've taken into consideration potential areas for vandalism or graffiti, so we've placed shrubs in areas where maybe inviting for a graffiti artist to place their art. I will also say that the Rotary Clubs are committed to maintaining this, all of this new building for eternity, basically based upon the five Rotary Clubs of Salinas. We're not only building a budget, but hands on the ground maintenance program that's going to take care of any vandalism or graffiti that might take place. So some conceptual ideas of the original kiosco. I'll also say I think it's worth mentioning. So about 6 months ago, as we were busy at work for this project, I asked President Brett. I said, Brett, how are we going to judge our success of this project when we're done? And his answer was very direct and simple, and that was that we've engaged the community so much that 10 years, 20 years from now, we can drive by the park and we can see our beautiful kiosco and plaza. And know that the community has been engaged in a sense of ownership and kept it looking really nice. So we've really put a lot of emphasis on that. Can you put the other slide up? So construction's going to start the first week of April. We're going to have basically four volunteer working Saturdays, including Cinco de Mayo, which will be the last day that you can purchase bricks. On any given Saturday out there, you can expect to find a large number of Rotarians, community members, working together side by side to eliminate the riffraff that sometimes congregates in this park and to ultimately beautify the park. This is the most recent design. This is the one that will be built. As you can see, there's been some minor changes, like I had mentioned before, the ramp and then some of the architectural ironwork. Ladies and gentlemen, that's La Plaza Rotario. I'll be happy to answer any of your questions.
Thank you, John. All right. Any questions from council? Okay. Any comment from the public? Do not step on children, Al. It will jeopardize your position on the Rec Commission.
I'll be careful.
All right.
As a Rec Park commissioner that sees the Closter Park on a daily basis for the most part, I try to envision this as it was presented, and I'll tell you, I can't thank the Rotarians and the other funders that have stepped up to make this happen. And even at our meeting, not just last night, but the one we had a couple weeks ago at St. Mary's, the community is buying in. And I told the speaker last night, as I did at our last meeting, that some of the people associate me with Parks and Rec, and I had gotten some phone calls wanting to know who was going to manage the calendar because they wanted to have quinceañeras, which is real big in our community. But I just wanted to thank the Rotarians, and I hope that all of you support this, as most of the community, I'm sure, will. Thank you.
Good. Thanks, Al. Okay. Careful on your way back. Anyone else from the public?
Good afternoon. I'm Doug Brown, and I am a Rotarian. And my wife worked in the LaSalle Union Elementary School District her entire career. And while at work during the daytime, witnessed various actual shootings. For me, one of the pieces, I know my time is limited, so I'll just contain it to that one. The kiosco itself. I also speak Spanglish. And so immediately I wanted to know, well, what does kiosco mean? What, the obvious is a kiosk. Well, it's more than a kiosk. It looked, and somebody said, well, you know, just what is that? And I said, well, think of it as a bandstand. Well, for us Anglos, yeah, it looks like a bandstand. But I know that I've come to learn that in the Latino community, the kiosco is a center of cultural community activity, not just once in a while, not just for a quinceañera, not just for a wedding, but every day, all day, half the night, and all weekend long. And this is not something we will have to teach the community to gradually come to use. The Latino population out there is abuzz about this. They are so excited. It's like giving a teenager a car. They know what to do with it right away. Sometimes you wish they wouldn't, but they know that once it's built, it's not that they will come. They will be there before it's built, seeing that it's built, and it will be used from day one. And the critical thing is, to me, I see this entire project as the glue that will put back together a fractured community. Thank you. All right.
What the hell? All right, anyone else from the public? I was going to give my lecture about democracy is not a spectator sport, but even I'm tired of that one. So.
Good afternoon, Ted Rico with the Center for Community Advocacy, the Poder Popular Program. I just wanted to say that it's interesting, and I want to really commend everyone who's been involved in this, especially the Rotaries. Several years ago when we were doing organizing work in East Salinas and talking with the community about what they wanted, this is what they were talking about. They were talking about wanting to feel like there was a center of the community, and what they described was a plaza. They mentioned the Watsonville Placita as sort of a model of what they wanted. So I really, again, I want to just commend everyone who's been involved in this, because everyone is making happen what people dreamed about. So congratulations, everyone.
Thank you. All right. I just love it when we have the symphony in the house. We get a lot of applause. All right, Ricky.
Good afternoon. Ricky Cabrera, president of the LaSalle Rotary Club. I just want to give you a little bit of an insight regarding the community engagement. The comments that we have received have been incredible. Tony, you've been there. They're too good to be true, you know, at that level. The community is really excited. They feel it's going to change the nature of the park. They even feel their property value is going to increase. They're excited left and right. They're on board to help us in whichever way they can. There was a lady there last night, and she was saying, I can't work, but I can cook. I mean, everybody's really excited. The community, the local community, they're crazy about the idea. And it's really important to see the community engaged like that. It'll bring a lot of pride and honor to that, and they themselves are saying that is going to help tremendously with the gang violence. Thank you,
Matt. Make a note to check if property values go up. We want to tax that. All right. Any anyone else? Hey, more services. All right. Anyone else? All right, back to council.
Mr. Mayor, I would, as you already know, it takes a lot of people to create positive change in our community. I would like all the volunteers, the Rotarians that are here that have been consistent in these meetings, in putting this thing together, I would please stand up, and we want to recognize all the Rotarians. Thank you very much.